couple of minutes ago, we talked about the fact that, well, we might need to change our design a lot. So how are we going to do that? That's going to be expensive. Well, it's not very expensive if we can do efficient refactoring, which is another one of the important XP practices. And what does it mean to refactor? It means to take a piece of code whose design might be suboptimal because, for example, we evolved it. We didn't take into account from the beginning some of the features that had to be added later, probably because we didn't even know about this feature because the requirements evolved. So we're going to take this piece of code and we're going to restructure it so that it becomes simple and maintainable. Developers are expected to refactor as soon as opportunities for improvement are found. And that happens, for example, before adding some code. You might look at the code that you're about to modify or to which you're about to add parts and say, can we change the program to make the addition simple? That helps maintainability. Or we can do it after adding some code to our code base. We might look at the code, the resulting code, and say, well, can we make the program simpler while still running all the tests? And the key point here is that we don't want to refactor on speculation, but we want to refactor on demand when the system and the process need it. Again, the goal is just to keep the code simple and maintainable, not to overdo it. And as I mentioned before, we're going to have a whole lesson, the next lesson, on refactoring. So we're going to go in more depth in the discussion of this topic.